गुड मॉर्निंग सर, थैंक यू सर।
प्रणव विजयवर्गीय, विजयवर्गीय, यू आर फ्रॉम राजस्थान ओनली?
यस सर, जयपुर।
सम सिमिलर नेम वॉज देयर दैट वेस्ट बंगाल बीजेपी इंचार्ज, सेम?
यस सर, सर नेम इज सेम, मिस्टर कैलाश विजयवर्गीय।
टेल मी समथिंग अबाउट दिस, यू हैव डन सम, यू हैव वन सम अवार्ड फ्रॉम सीएम हरियाणा।
यस सर,
इंपैक्टफुल वर्क, व्हाट वाज दैट?
सर, इट वॉज अ फेलोशिप विच वॉज स्टार्टेड बाय अशोका यूनिवर्सिटी इन कॉलेबोरेशन विद हरियाणा गवर्नमेंट। सो वी वर पोस्टेड इन द डिस्ट्रिक्ट ऑफ हरियाणा टू वर्क विद डिस्ट्रिक्ट एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन एंड आई डिड अ पायलट प्रोजेक्ट ऑन सॉलिड वेस्ट मैनेजमेंट।
विच डिस्ट्रिक्ट एंड व्हेन, हाउ मेनी मंथ्स?
इन 2016 फॉर वन ईयर आई वॉज पोस्टेड इन सोनीपत। सो आई वर्क विद द म्युनिसिपल कॉर्पोरेशन ऑन अ पायलट प्रोजेक्ट, इट वॉज नेम सॉलिड वेस्ट मैनेजमेंट। And our main objective was to ensure segregation at source. And we were able to get 1,000 kg of waste per day and composted and converted into compost.
How many villages?
We did it in two localities of the urban Sonipat.
Okay, urban area.
Yes.
So for this project, I was awarded the impact.
So how much time you used to devote?
Sir, I worked it for almost for an entire year. And
that's full time?
No, not full time, it was one of the project, and I used to dedicate 3 to 4 hours every day to this project. So it was a continuous project which I worked.
And people have been cooperative?
No sir, it was a big challenge. Mm-hmm. So to convince the households and participate in the behavior change exercise was the biggest challenge. But the thing which worked out in our favor is that we had an year-long engagement with them. We built a team of volunteers to do the door-to-door campaigning.
But after that 2016, it was over. Did you find out whether it is still working or it is just gone?
Yes, sir. It is still continuing in the district. So the future associates, they are continuing the project.
They are continuing. Yes. And any lessons learned from this and which have been replicated in other districts?
Sir, a couple of districts are also working on the source segregation, the Ambala and the Yamunanagar. And the biggest learning is that for a sustainable waste management exercise, segregation at source is essential. And for segregation, behavior change of household is essential, which requires active engagement.
Tell me something about Rajasthan. Rajasthan, now this government is 3 years or 4 years?
So the assembly elections were in 2018. So it's been
three plus years. Okay. Tell me what 4 or 5 good things have done. And two, three things which you don't like of this government.
So the government is doing good work in the security of the women, the women education, also availability of water, because water scarcity is a bigger problem.
What they have done about water?
Sir, the government is planning to dig underground wells.
Planning, or they have done in 3.5 years? Still planning?
They have dug some wells and it is also in the pipeline, so they are digging more because water scarcity is a big problem. Other than that, there is also provisions for mandatory rooftop rainwater harvesting. Other than water, the government is actively pursuing the policy of attracting investments. So for that, the government has launched a policy on MSMEs. And another good work which the government is doing is on renewable energy. So recently in 2019, the government launched solar energy policy with the aim of 30 gigawatt power production from solar energy. So these are some of the good things which the government is doing. And one latent potential which has not been tapped because of the pandemic and other reasons is the tourist potential of the state. So Rajasthan has immense potential for tourists.
Okay, what things which you don't like this government?
Yes, sir. Sir, one is the waste management. So there is still no segregation at source and the policy has not been adopted by the government. So this is the biggest area which I think that the government should actively take.
Only one?
Yes sir, this is the biggest problem which is coming to my mind right now.
Infighting in politics going on, which because of which they have not been able to concentrate on that development?
Sir, I do not have a strong opinion on the political side because I believe that the parliamentary system of the government works in the tussle between the government.
That is okay. I am telling that affects your development. If you keep on fighting, yes, where is the time for doing development or work?
I agree, sir, that there should be better coordination between the government and lesser time should be spent.
Okay, okay. You appeared in the Indian Forest Service exam also? You're cleared?
So the interviews are scheduled.
Okay, and the engineering service?
That I could not qualify.
See, you would have read in the newspapers, Rahul Gandhi has given some definition to GDP.
Sir, I have not read his GDP, but I am aware of the actual GDP.
I'm asking his GDP. His GDP was gas, diesel and petrol rising.
I have not read, sir.
What is the difference between climate and weather?
Yes, sir. So weather is a short-term feature and climate is a long-term weather phenomena. So climate is a more general term which provides detail about...
How do we decide about the climate of an area?
Yes, sir. So there are different parameters. For instance, the average temperature, the range of annual temperature, the amount of precipitation, humidity. These are some of the parameters which decide.
Israel is called as a laboratory for development of climate resilience measures.
Yes, sir.
Can you give some examples how Israel is doing as compared to other countries?
Yes, sir. Israel is a pioneer in the fields of climate because it is investing a lot of amount and fund in the research and development. And with respect to the technologies, sir, it is investing a lot in water conservation. And for instance, the techniques of drip irrigation and sprinkler irrigation are pioneered by Israel. So because of investing a lot in research, it is a pioneer, sir.
Savings on even agriculture also, water.
Yes, sir.
Chandan Mitra was in news recently.
No, sir.
Line of actual control, yes, and LOC and international border.
Yes, sir.
What are the differences?
So line of actual control is the disputed border between India and China.
I am not asking about India or China. I am asking all these three. What is the difference?
Sir, as per my knowledge, the international borders are the settled borders. So there is no ambiguity or dispute between the international borders. But with respect to LAC and LOC, there is still not mutually accepted fixed borders and the participating...
No, but there must be difference between the LAC and LOC.
Sir, I'm only aware that LAC is between India and China and LOC is between India and Pakistan. And the borders are disputed.
Delhi has received the highest rainfall in the last 19 years. What is happening? Why is there such increase in precipitation?
Sir, one of the reason is the global increase in temperature because of global warming and climate change. Because of the increase in temperature, the air has higher capacity to hold the moisture. And because of higher capacity to hold moisture, there is greater precipitation in the region.
So how can the urbanization model in Delhi be made more climate resilient?
I think it requires a lot of efforts from the government side in the planning of infrastructure. Like in the design step itself, there needs to be consideration for climate resilience. Then there needs to be prioritization of afforestation and planting of trees across the district. For instance, the urban park should be designed. Then there should be provisions of urban lakes to regulate the climate. And then the other thing is on the awareness side. So the citizens needs to be aware on energy efficiency and utilization of renewable energy using public transportation. So these are some of the interventions which need.
Delhi government has opened schools. I think this is after the lockdown of 16-18 months. What do you think about this and what kind of safety measures or precautions are being taken while opening of schools?
So since the schools had been closed since last 17 years, they had to be opened gradually, and I think it is a right step because education is very important for the development of children. And the safeguards which has been taken is that the government has ensured that the staff is vaccinated, all the working teachers and the staffs are vaccinated. Then they have also ensured that the capacity should be fixed at 50% so that a lot of students does not end up at the same time. For instance, every student is sitting is on one bench, so social distancing is being practiced. And one last thing is they have utilized the online education as well. So they have integrated online education with opening of schools in their model.
Okay. Green hydrogen. It is in news. Can you tell me what is green hydrogen and its application in the automobile sector?
Yes, sir. So recently, the Honorable Prime Minister has launched the National Hydrogen Mission, which aims to create India as a hub for manufacturing of green hydrogen. So it is called green hydrogen because the process of manufacturing of green hydrogen is environment friendly, and renewable energy is used for the production in the process of electrolysis. So it is energy friendly, and its application in automobile sector is immense because of the fewer or no emissions from the automobiles. So it's a great step forward.
What are some of the initiatives or incentives given by the government for EV manufacturing in the country?
Yes, sir. Sir, one is the tax incentive. So under the GST, it is under the 5% tax bracket. So one is the tax incentive. Second is a lot of IEC campaign and the communication campaign has been done by the government to motivate people to go for electric vehicles. Then there is dedicated policies and schemes. For instance, the FAME scheme, fast adoption of and manufacturing of electric vehicles. These are the interventions which I could think of. Right?
You have what you call? One more question I was thinking. Okay. Ashoka University was in news with respect to Pradap Manu Behta controversy. Can you tell me what happened? What was the issue and what is the current status?
So the main issue was that Mr. Pratap Bhanu Mehta, he was alleged to be writing against the government, criticizing the government, and the argument from him was that he was pursuing his academic freedom and he was well within his rights. So because of the issue of curbing his academic freedom, he had to resign.
Where do you stand? What is your opinion on this?
Sir, I believe that academic freedom should be allowed because criticizing the government is the right of everyone and we should not curb the dissent. So until unless there is a major public interest issue, we should allow academic freedom.
Supreme Court yesterday, I think, or day before yesterday, talked about social media and the kind of content that is being propagated on social media. Are you aware of this?
Sir, I'm aware of the statement that the Honorable Chief Justice has made about the communalization of the news that has been happening.
What do you think?
Yes, sir. I agree with him that the social media has been used in creating rumors, misinformation, and communalization as well. And therefore, the government has also come up with the draft regulations to regulate the social media.
What was your role as an associate at Ashoka University?
Yes, sir. Sir, it was the fellowship which was started by Ashoka University in collaboration with Haryana government. So we had to work with the district administration and we had mainly three roles. One was to do the pilot project, which I had done in solid waste management. Sir, another was we had been assigned specifically designed modules which were focused on good governance and had been designed in consultation with the departmental heads. And third was we had to assist the deputy commissioner of the district in whatever work he needs our help in. So these were the three main roles. Focus at good governance in the district of Sonipat.
The new education policy has proposed something called as an academic credit bank.
Yes.
Can you tell me what is this and how does this work?
Sir, it is related to higher education. So it is giving more autonomy and flexibility to students that they can pursue courses, they can exit at their will, work for some time. Whatever learnings and credits they have earned, it would be stored in the academic bank of credit. Then let's say after some time, if they again want to do more courses, then the newer credits would cumulatively accumulate in the bank. So it is giving more autonomy and flexibility to students.
You have a hobby of bird photography.
Yes, sir.
Can you tell me some prominent Indian bird photographer?
Yes, sir. So Mr. Bikram Grewal is a pioneer in the field of bird photography. So I am following.
Where do you take photography?
Sir, I try to observe birds in my day-to-day lives. So there are a lot of trees around my areas. Occasionally I go on morning walks. And when I was in Jaipur, I also used to visit a few lakes.
So what is the rarest bird that you photographed?
So the rarest bird that I have photographed is, I would say, the coppersmith barbet. So
We're talking about waste management in Glen. So what is the battery waste management role?
battery waste comes under the category of e-waste, and the government has released the notification on e-waste management rules, under which the manufacturers of the e-waste or the batteries have been given the responsibility for the end-of-life disposal of the waste.
So if I have to dispose of a dead battery, how do I go about it?
Yes, ma'am. So ma'am, the household has to segregate waste into three categories: the dry waste, the wet waste, and the hazardous waste. So the battery waste would go into the category of hazardous waste, and then in a segregated manner, it needs to be provided to the waste collector, who then recycles it or disposes it in an environmentally friendly manner.
I don't have this option of somebody coming and collecting this from me. Where do I go for this, for disposing of this dead battery?
Yes, ma'am. This is a major on the part of the municipal corporation, that there is no system in place. And as a good citizen, what a household can do is to segregate it in an isolation manner, and then it needs to be on a volunteer basis. It needs to be contacted to the manufacturer, provided him, for instance, whatever.
Should I go back to the manufacturer, or is there any agency or anything, any department of waste management, department of administration?
We need to contact the municipal corporation, that we need to provide this segregated e-waste. So it is the responsibility of the corporation.
You've been living in Delhi for some time now. So how is Delhi government handling waste management? We don't see it in news anywhere. Delhi government is taking up a lot of other initiatives, but there is no initiative. We have never read in news about waste management. Is there a problem of waste management in Delhi or not? First question.
There is a problem. Because although the waste collection has been streamlined, but there is no focus on segregation. And without segregation, the management of waste is very, very difficult. So there is a problem.
So if there is a problem and it is not anywhere in the news, is Delhi government doing something with regards to waste management?
Ma'am, the government is working on the finalization of waste to energy plans. So the government is currently focusing on secondary segregation, wherein the mixed waste is collected from the households, and then before taking it to the plant, the workers segregate it. But secondary segregation is not very useful, and there's very less efforts in household behavior change to segregate the waste at source. So the government is focusing on energy and secondary segregation rather than primary segregation.
Energy by energy, what do you mean?
Ma'am, the waste to energy, for instance, the incineration, the gasification, these are some of the technologies.
So have heard about this waste thing in Banwari, that mountain, that Gurgaon Faridabad road. Since you live in Delhi and it is very, very, something which everyone is familiar with. And there also the government is trying, the administration is trying to convert the energy, waste to energy plant, and they have already identified places. But activists are against it. So what do you think that is the reason?
Ma'am, I'm not aware of why activists are opposing it, because the government is doing a right thing in establishing waste to energy plants and reducing the volume from the landfill site. But
there are implications if they do that. So just wanting to know if you are aware of it.
Ma'am, one issue is that if we supply mixed waste to a waste to energy plant, then there will be a lot of harmful emissions from the plant, which may result in air pollution. So we need to ensure that we provide segregated waste to the plant so that it could function optimally. So this is one of the reasons that the government is not focusing on waste segregation at source, providing mixed waste to the site.
So is it a right step that, you already have mixed, waste with you, and then you are, converting this into the energy, and then there will be a lot of poisonous harmful gases which will come out. So is it a good step of the administration to be doing this?
For the waste that has already been landed at the landfill site, we have no remedy. We have to segregate it as a postmortem itself. But as a long-term measure, we need to focus on source.
Delhi Transport Department has issued an advisory to get old vehicle scrap. And recently, you know, even the central government has also come out with this scrappage policy. So what is the difference? This is in news nowadays again. So what is the difference there? What is Delhi government saying? And how it is different from what central government is saying? Their policy.
No, I'm not aware of the differences. I'm only aware that the vehicles, the diesel vehicles and the petrol vehicles who are 15 years and 20 years old, they need to be scrapped. So fine differences between
20 or 10-15?
I'm sorry, sir, 10-15.
Okay, now coming to Rajasthan. So there's a railway station in Rajasthan which has got a green tag. You are aware of it? Fine. And coming to trekking and mountaineering. So which has been your favorite destination for trekking?
Ma'am, I did a basic mountaineering course in the Ladakh region. So there I went on a snow trek, which was an amazing experience for me.
For how long? How many days?
The mountaineering course was of 28 days.
28 days. And what was the criteria?
Ma'am, we had to fill an application form. So based on the first come first serve basis.
So no fitness test, nothing?
Fitness test is done after they select. So the first 3 days was the fitness test, and who qualifies stays and who does not was sent back.
There are a lot of treks which are banned in India. So are you aware of it, and very well known treks, or they're on the verge of banning?
Ma'am, there's still no clear guidelines on the regulations of tracking, and on an occasional basis, based on timings. So for instance, some of the high mountain treks are not allowed in the winter reasons because of the associated risk of landslides. So in the high mountain snow region, some of the treks are banned.
You are from North Delhi. There is a park in North Delhi known as Coronation Park. What is the historical significance of that park?
Yes, sir, I have not heard.
Okay, no problem. And you were an associate at Ashoka University.
Yes, sir.
Ashoka University was in news also. So Pranav, do you think student politics is necessary?
Yes, sir. I think student politics is necessary because it's a very good platform for students to develop leadership qualities and excel future in life. So I agree.
Leadership qualities or controversial qualities?
Sir, I would say leadership qualities.
Leadership qualities. Okay, no problem. You have mentioned mountaineering is one of your hobbies.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so can you tell me what is the highest peak in India?
Yes, sir. So the K2 is the highest peak of India.
K2 or Kanchenjunga?
Sir, K2 is in Pakistan occupied Kashmir, which is a territory of India.
Okay, good. Pranav, you were born in Rajasthan, right?
Yes.
So can you tell me, we see that there is a conflict on the J&K border, something on the Punjab border, but we don't hear of any conflict on the Rajasthan or Gujarat border. So why that phenomena is there? Why the borders of Rajasthan and Gujarat quite peaceful?
So the interstate borders?
No, the international border with Pakistan.
Yes, sir. Because the borders between India and Pakistan in the Gujarat Rajasthan region is international borders, so they are settled borders. But the borders of Jammu and Kashmir, so they had a history since the time of partition, when the instrument of accession was signed by the Maharaja of Kashmir. So since then, the border is categorized as LOC border, which is conflicted. So I think that is the reason.
Okay. Has it got something to do with the weather?
Sir, I'm not aware.
Bird photography. So can you tell me what is the state bird of Rajasthan?
Yes, sir. It's a great Indian bustard.
And what is the state bird of Delhi?
Sir, house sparrow.
House sparrow. Okay. Pranav, you must be observing that currently in Afghanistan, a resistance is going on in Panjshir Valley. And the leader of the resistance has also appealed to the international community to help them in whatever way possible. So do you think as a sovereign government, we should actually help out the rebels there?
Sir, I don't think we should participate there in the internal conflicts of the region. What we should do is to have a conversation with the major stakeholders to secure Indian interests. And not go beyond that. So we should not interfere and we should not support the rebels.
But the rebels are led by the former vice president of Afghanistan, who has also said he is the acting president. And we had our diplomatic relations with that government. So why we should not support them? I think we should.
Yes, so because India has a foreign policy of non-interference. So we as a country do not want other countries to interfere in our internal conflicts. So as a reciprocating effect, India should also not interfere in their internal politics and the struggles.
Okay. Pranav, there is a term in diplomacy called as wolf warrior diplomacy. So what do you understand by that term?
Sir, I've heard of the term in the context of China, but I do not know the exact definition.
Okay. Have you heard of the Wakhan corridor?
Yes.
Which countries does it connect?
Sir, it is in Afghanistan, in the bordering region with Pakistan.
Pakistan or China?
Sir, I'm confusing.
Okay. You can read about it. You were in IIT Bombay for your graduation. Can you tell me the historical significance of Gateway of India? There were two important events associated with it.
Sir, I am aware of one of the attack, not historic significance, but a blot on in which some of the terrorists came via the Gateway of India and attacked the city of Mumbai. Sir, I'm able to think of this incident right now.
Okay. So, you must have seen that currently US troops left Afghanistan. So, British troops also left India in 1948. Is it associated with that, Gateway of India?
Sir, I would have to read.
Okay. Thank you, Pranav.